It's good to see you, Colt.
Oh, it's good to see you, man. It's good to be back.
How's it feel to be back? I mean, I know it's, you know, I've been a long time coming, but ready, better to be prepared than to just rush it, huh?
Yeah, I think that was the whole goal, is just try and be somewhat prepared. Shoulder just took a lot longer than I thought. It was kind of surprising. I didn't think it was going to be that long, but it was kind of some nerve issue we were dealing with as well. And it would just ache and ache and ache, kind of felt like a toothache, you know, all the time. Then we finally got over that hump, and then it was just like, okay, let's try to get back up to speed. And, you know, that takes a minute, you know, it's not like that comes back overnight. So just getting comfortable on the bike, and we made a lot of changes and still kind of progressing. It seems like the speed gets better, then the bike gets better, then the speed gets better, and, you know, the bike's kind of coming with. So it's been good, man. I'm just really excited to be back behind the gate. It's been, like I said, a long time, so I'm excited.
Okay, you know, we know that developing a new bike always comes with its own share of challenges and everything like that. How's it been for you to take that on? I mean, you knew that that was going to be part of the experience of being part of this team, but just to go through it, work with these guys, see what they're capable of.
I mean, it's exactly that. It's growing pains, you know. It's really exciting for the fact that we didn't have any direction. You know, we had no base for anything, no data. So it's like, where do we set the sag? Wherever feels comfortable, wherever that is. So it's kind of funny the way it works. But then at the same time, it's got a lot of its issues, you know, stuff that you don't think about. You know, your durability testing parts a lot of times, and, you know, going through so much stuff and trying stuff. I mean, testing honestly isn't fun. It's just fun when you see the result that it gets. And for me, it's been cool because, like I said, pre A1 to now, the bike's in a completely different space. You know, it's just a completely different motorcycle. Kind of feels like top to bottom. And the team has just been doing a lot of work to try and get me comfortable and trying different stuff, getting some input from some different people. You know, a lot of people under this tent are new and green, and not in a bad way. It's just, you know, we don't have a whole lot of experience, and that goes with everybody. So it's just cool, you know, to see where it's gotten to and how much further we can go with it. It's cool having another year to work and grow with this brand, and man, that's just exciting. It's good for me.
You've been a lifelong race fan, and you have so many people in your corner that have gone through the same thing. So you know, it's not like it's a complete, I'm the first person ever going through this. Like, you've seen enough people, you knew that this was coming, so you just kind of take it on.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much. That's all you can do, you know. But it's been, like I said, a fun, exciting thing, knowing that I'm going to be here for a little bit. You know, like, even the Honda thing last year was tough just because you feel like you're kind of sitting on borrowed time a little bit, you know. And here, it's like, okay, I'm here for 2 years. You know, like, we can get comfortable with something. And once we make progress and we get there, we can kind of continue. You know, like, last year, the time I liked my bike the most was the last time I rode it, you know, at Nashville. And then I got hurt right after that, and it was like, damn, you know, that kind of sucks. I was just starting to kind of come around to it. So for here, it's cool. You know, we can build, we can learn. And like I said, hopefully, you know, they're using me to kind of steer this ship in a certain direction, and I think that's pretty special.
Okay. Last thing is completely off the topic of how's that motorcycle and Colt racing and all that stuff. You're a lifelong race fan. I know you watch everything. You've been to F1.
Oh, yeah.
Been to MotoGP?
No MotoGP, just F1.
Okay. You've been to the pinnacle of motorsports. Mm. You've seen, especially with the fashion stuff that you're into, like how motorsport is in fashion all the time right now. Why do you think that? And then what are your thoughts on it?
As far as why it's in there?
Why? Yeah, like, I have my thoughts on it. I mean, I think, like, what's cooler than this? What's cooler than watching, like, death-defying stuff and the best colors and the travel that goes around, and it's always young guys that are racing, and it's always, like, super sexy looking.
Yeah.
And I think that's what makes it attractive to fashion, because you're always going after those same people.
Yeah.
And this has gone on for decades. Like, if you watch, like, old Steve McQueen movies, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
It's just doing it back then. But from a guy that, you know, lives and breathes it as this guy, but also is interested in the fashion stuff, like, what do you think about it?
I mean, I think it's something that's like, just like anything, it's progression, you know? Like you said, it's been around for forever, but when it comes to having new things involved with new sports, it's always frowned upon at first. That's just the way, you know, society is with everything. And but you look at every other major sport, that's the way it is, you know? It's turned into more than what the game or what the sport is. You know, these people want to see who you are. You know, you have your diehard motocross fans that are, you know, load it in the back of the truck, show up, get dirty, hang out at Unadilla and do that. And then you have the guys that are trying to progress and make this sport something a lot bigger. And honestly, I feel like as much as people hate to hear it, I mean, that's how you do things like that. That's how you progress. That's how you make things better. And the sport is in such a good spot right now. Like, it's rich with, I mean, competitiveness and the enthusiasm every weekend. I mean, I feel like we're getting so spoiled right now as like Supercross fans just for how cool it is. Like, where it could go, I feel like it is kind of I mean, kind of through the roof, to be honest with you, with how competitive the field is and how tight the points race is and just kind of where everyone is. I mean, dude, it's a crazy spot right now. Fuck off, Benny. But I don't know. it's definitely growing. It's got a lot of room to grow, and I think that's one way we do it. But no, the sports is in a really good spot. It really is.
I mean, all the Alpine Stars collab stuff that has come out in the last
unreal.
10 days
yeah.
is unreal.
Yeah.
And I love wearing Alpine Stars stuff because it's a racing brand first and foremost. And then to see them do that, I know people are doing it not because they're just trying to bite that style. I mean, think of how many times that logo's been ripped off in the last few years.
Mm-hmm.
The people that are going to them with that approval and getting, we want to work with you.
Yeah.
That's a real appreciation for what that company is that you trust in every single day.
Oh, yeah, 100%. And that's like, for me, that's what I would love to do. You know, I want to get people that have inspiration for, you know, design and, you know, to try and push the boundary a little bit when it comes to what you're wearing, how you're wearing it, the materials it's getting made with, kind of everything. You know, that's how you keep progressing with everything. That's how the bikes progress. You know, you try something new, then all of a sudden it sticks on everything that's there. So same stuff with what we're doing. But no, like I said, it's in a really good spot. I'm hoping that I can do that with the brands I'm involved with, you know, make it a cool brand that people want to be a part of, you know, and hopefully I can be the face for it. That would be really special for me. And luckily I got good people behind me that are letting me do that with O'Neill and HJC and guys that just kind of see the vision a little bit. It's cool.